Breaking news is on the Russia investigation. The president says he believes special counsel Robert Mueller will treat him fairly. But he says the investigation, quote, makes the country look very bad. That's according to the New York Times, which also reports the president insisted a stunning 16 times there has been no collusion discovered by Mueller's investigation. But the president also returned to a familiar theme, complaining that Attorney General Jeff Sessions recused himself and pointedly saying, quote, Holder protected President Obama. A lot to get to, but I want to start with Michael Scheer, who helped break the story for the New York Times. He's also a CNN political analyst, and he joins us now via Skype. Michael, I'm so glad that you could join us for this story that's in the New York Times this evening. Your colleague, sure. Michael Schmidt, landed an impromptu interview with the president today, and the big headline, he believes the special counsel will treat him fairly in the Russia investigation.
Yeah, no, that's right. It was about a half an hour interview and totally impromptu down at the president's golf club in West Palm Beach, Florida. But there was a lot there. The thing that struck us most was the comments that the president made about the Russia investigation, notably that he thought Bob Mueller was going to be fair to him, which really undercuts and undermines an argument that many in his party have been making for the last several weeks, that they've been attempting to discredit and undermine Mueller's investigation, calling it partisan. So this kind of goes against that. But at the same time, as you said, the president repeated a lot of the complaints and criticisms that he's had about the investigation. And in fact, at one point said that made a reference to the Justice Department and said that he thought he could do whatever he wants with the Justice Department, although for the moment he's not doing that.
Okay. A lot to get through in this article. Let me read this part of it again. It says, it makes the country look very bad and it puts the country in a very bad position. So the sooner it's worked out, the better it is for the country. And then again, he reiterated 16 times that there has been no collusion, at least that's what he believes.
Right. I mean, so the bit about what it looks like for the country came after Mike asked him a question about timing and whether or not he was concerned that the investigation wasn't concluding more quickly. That you'll remember that the president's aides had reported to him they thought the investigation would end first by Thanksgiving and then by the end of this year. It's clearly not ending that quickly. And so Mike said, does that concern you? And what the president said was, no, it doesn't concern me, except that it's really bad for the country. And he sort of repeated that in a bunch of different ways, saying that he thought that the longer this goes on, the worse it is for the country.
Let's talk a little bit more about what you just said. And I'm going to read the quote here. It says, I have absolute right to do what I want to do with the Justice Department. But for purposes of hopefully thinking I'm going to be treated fairly, I've stayed uninvolved with this particular matter. And that's a quote from the piece from the president. Talk to me more about that. What was this in response to? Do you know?
Yeah. So Mike had been discussing the Russia investigation, and that naturally turns, as it often does with the president. The president sort of made it turn to the email in the inquiry involving Hillary Clinton. And so at one point, Mike said to the president, you have control over the Justice Department, right? Are you going to order them to renew the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails? The president's answer, which you just read, is entirely verbatim of what he said following that question. And it seemed to sort of skip over the part about Hillary Clinton and really focus more on the part about the Justice Department and whether or not he controls it. Because as you read, it's really not a reference that we can determine anyway to the Hillary Clinton emails. It's really more a reference back to Russia, back to this question about whether or not Bob Mueller is going to be fair to him. And he does, indicate this belief that I think he and a lot of his supporters have, which is that, they believe that he has the control, that ultimately the Justice Department reports to him and that it's up to him whether the investigation, continues or ends.
How did Jeff Sessions come up, and then how did he sort of turn it into former Attorney General Eric Holder?
I believe, and we did. I don't have this entirely committed to memory, but I believe the question was put to him about Jeff Sessions, and he said again, I wish he hadn't recused himself. And then Mike asked him a question, I think following that, about loyalty. Does that call into question his loyalty or something? And his response was, you know, to bring up Mr. Holder and to say, you know, well, let me tell you about Mr. Holder. And basically, he didn't directly answer the question of loyalty. In fact, he said, look, I don't want to deal with loyalty. But he went on to suggest that Eric Holder, unlike, I mean, left unstated, but clearly unlike Jeff Sessions, was his point, that Eric Holder had protected President Obama during what the president and Republicans like to call scandals involving involving that White House. He raised the IRS, you know, controversy surrounding the IRS and gun running and the issues on the border with guns that, you know, both of which were sort of scandals on Capitol Hill. And he suggested that Mr. Holder had protected President Obama in a way that clearly he doesn't think Jeff Sessions has protected him.
He's talking about Fast and Furious, which and those things, none of which, not much came of any of that. But thank you. I thought it was fascinating, too, Michael, before I let you go, that he gave the interview. And it says, this is what from the New York Times. He gave the interview in the grill room at Trump International Golf Course after he ate lunch with his playing partners, including his son Eric and a pro golfer, Jim Herman. No aides were present for the interview, and the president sat alone with the New York Times reporter at a large round table at the club. Members chatted and ate lunch nearby. People came back, including his friend, back and forth, including his friend Chris Ruddy as well. So it was, I thought it was interesting that there were no aides there.
No aides, and if you look at the story, and we actually have, I think, a partial transcript up as well now on the site, there's lots of other little tidbits, some of which are, you know, just kind of funny little moments. There was one in which he said he was talking about the tax bill, and he took issue with reports that maybe he doesn't have as much detailed knowledge about the tax bill and other legislation that's gone through
Congress. I have the quote here. It says, Mr. Trump disputed reports that suggested that he does not have a detailed understanding of the legislation, saying, I know the details of taxes better than anybody, better than the greatest CPA. I know the details of health care better than most, better than most.
Yeah, it was that kind of interview. He was very un, you know,